Welcome to a quick guide on the basic electronics components you must know, including their symbols and their functions. So before you build any real-world circuits or dive deeper into electronics, you need to recognize the basic electronics components and their symbols because they form the alphabet of the circuit diagrams you're going to be working with. So to get started, we're going to be starting with one of the major electronic components, which happens to be the mother of electronics, because every other component has an element of it, which is the basic component is the resistor. The resistor symbol is zigzag or rectangular, depending on the standard that is being considered. And here is a live breadboard connection of a resistor with an LED. So this is a Tinkercad simulation of how to use a resistor as a current limiter for an LED in this circuit. So you can see we are using this resistor here to limit the flow of current. So it limits how much current passes through the LED and any other sensitive components you are going to be using. All right, so there are other functions of the resistor other than using it as a current limiter, but for the course of this video we're going to be focusing largely on using the resistor as a current limiter. Right, other functions of the resistor were like using it as a voltage divider, we'll be discussing subsequent videos. Right, but primarily the resistor is used to control the flow of current passing through other components in the circuit. So this is still the resistor that is creating resistance, so it's creating resistance to the flow of current going to this LED. Now see what happens to the LED. When I increase the resistance, you see it reduces the current more and more, and you can see the LED shining again. The LED is no longer shining. Why? Because of the too much resistance that is provided by the resistor. All right, so when I reduce the resistance of the resistor, the brightness of the LED increases. All right, so you can see now when there is no resistance at all, it got burnt. So you could see the LED when it got burnt. Why? Because it means that the resistor is playing a very crucial role in this simple LED circuit. All right, so you can see how resistor is used to control the flow of current in. Next, we'll talk about the capacitor. So their symbol is two parallel lines, or one straight and one curved line for polarized types. So these are the various types of capacitors that we have. You can see the various types of capacitor. So capacitors primarily is used to store and release electrical energy or charges. So it can be used to smooth out voltage changes, to filter noise, like when you are building a rectifier circuit, or you can use it to provide a temporary power boost. And in this circuit, I built a charging and discharging of a capacitor. So this is a charging and discharging capacitor circuit. All right, so this circuit work in such that when the push button used in this circuit, which is the switch now, when it's not pressed, when we don't press the push button, the LED stays on. Why? Because the capacitor is discharging the voltage that it has stored from the battery to the LED to power the LED. So that's the discharging. All right, so but when we press the push button, you can see the LED goes off. Why? Because as at that time the capacitor is charging, so the 9 volt battery is charging the capacitor. So this is a charging and discharging of a capacitor. So where we get to charge or discharge capacitor. So if you know how the camera that we normally use to snap works, write something about it in the comment section from what we've talked about. Moving on to our next basic electronics component is the diode. The diode symbol is an arrow pointing to a line showing the one-way direction of current flow. So these are the various types of diodes that we have, and these are the various symbols for different types of diodes. So here is a circuit, a diode circuit, and here is the diode symbol used in a circuit where I showed that diode allows current to flow in just one direction. That's how diode work. It allows currents to flow in one direction. And when a diode emits light, it's called light emitting diode. But this is just a regular diode, and this one is just to show the forward biasing of the diode, meaning allowing current to flow in just one direction. Now see when the diode is reverse biased, so you can use it to block current in a circuit. You can see the block from the symbol. See how it's working in this circuit. It's not allowing current to pass. Why? Because it allows current to flow in only one direction. Now see what we said about when a diode emits light. That's when it's called light emitting diode. And you can see this one is forward bias. And see now, let's talk about transistors. Transistors are used as electronics switches or amplifiers. All right. So there are two major types of transistors. We have the BJT and then we have the FET. But in this video, we're going to be focusing more on the BJT transistor. All right. So the PNP under the BJT means that it requires a negative voltage to bias it, while the NPN means it requires a positive voltage to bias it. So you can see the symbols of the transistors. All right. So we're going to be focusing on the BJT transistor, that is a bipolar junction transistor, in this video, because we're considering the basic electronic components. So here is a transistor circuit. We already said that transistor is an electronic component that can be used either as a switch or as an amplifier. So in this circuit, I'm using the transistor as a switch to switch on this LED. So I put the switch in the place of the base of the transistor because I want to show you how I'm using the transistor as a switch. So this is the symbol of the transistor on the Protus diagram that I'm using to simulate this transistor circuit. All right, so you can see the symbol of the transistor. So the transistor symbol has three connections, which is the base that is connected to one terminal of the resistor, all right, that is down to the positive power supply, and then we have the emitter and the collector. So here is a live demo. Now let's talk about something you're already familiar with because you use them every day, switches. So this is a push button, which is also a switch, and these are various types of switches and their symbols. So we use switches to allow or block current. Of course, you use them every day. And here is a breadboard of a push button that I'm using to switch on the LED through the transistor. All right, so this is a Protus demo of the breadboard connection I just showed you earlier. It's the same thing, there is no difference. All right, so you can see the function of this switch is to close the path for the transistor to be biased. Before we wrap up, let's mention two essential parts of any circuit: ground and power supply. Although we can't classify them as basic electronic components, but they are very essential when building basic electronic circuits. So these are the three major types of ground: signal ground, chassis ground, and we have the earth ground. And then we have the power supply, which batteries are most often used to represent our power supply when building basic electronic circuits. And here is a circuit I simulated using every circuit on my mobile phone. It's a mobile app. Every circuit, I get to demonstrate how essential ground and the power supply, in this case the 9-volt battery, is used in building a basic electronic circuit that you can see on screen. All right, so here the battery happens to be the voltage source, and you can see the symbols of both the battery and the ground. And you can see that the battery provides the energy that drives the circuit, and then the ground shows the reference point, that is where current needs to return.
So guys, did you enjoy this video? If you did, smash
the subscribe button, like, just give me a thumbs up, and drop your comment about the video and the next project you would want me to upload in this channel. And see you in my next video. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.